Tour time. We got the luggage. We got the gigantic mirror. Hello. This is the fit. What y'all think? We got Hokas on the feet because I get feet cramps. We got Zara sweatsuit, Baze on the pouch, Princess Polly on the jacket, and a bun because I wanted to wash my hair. And if I wasn't vlogging, it would look cute, but right now my arm's all bunched up, so it makes me look funny, but it is cute. Behind this gigantic mirror, got drawers, snacks, storage, and then closet, bathroom. Okay, bathroom. Some essentials. We're here to celebrate the Delicia Drench body butter launch, which I need because my hands are shredding to death because I was stressed and my eczema flares up when I'm stressed. If you think I'm lying, I'm not, because my hands are cracked. Then of course the new Sarosa 59, the coordinating fragrance, which is clinically proven to boost your mood, which I feel like all of us need that right now because we've had a long travel day. I sprayed this all over myself at home before I came, so I'm pretty locked in, but I'm still gonna be using this every single day. We have leave-in conditioner, which never hurts, and of course hair oil, which also never hurts. And then you come over here, you have a little bit of a snack situation, and then we got our welcome to the W. And then we have this double bed situation, and I appreciate that. I appreciate the extra space. Like, one can be the toss bed and one can be the sleeping bed. You got a little footstep up, and then our little goodie bag. We have gloves, we have hats, we have a water bottle, we have a welcome card, hello. Oh, with all our full itinerary on it. And then essentials.
I also want to include that we are going to pick the winner for my last soul giveaway from our last travel vlog at the end of this video. We're going to pick it when I get home. I'm going to show you guys the box, all that good stuff. And then I'm going to do another little giveaway for y'all in the comments of this video. I am looking hurt. All I have on is lashes and brow gel because I got delayed 2.5 hours at my connecting flight. And a lot of people had travel problems today. There was snow yesterday, etc. So I just want to wash up and get my face right. Cause look at how dehydrated I look. Look at how much my moisture bearer is struggling right now. My hands look frail and aged. I was looking at them on the plane. I was like, yo, this like plane like sucks the life out of you. And it does. Like, my lips are like a whole different color right now. So dinner got pushed back for some logistical reasons.
As a girl who sleeps with a humidifier, I appreciate that. I appreciate that so much. I brought both Baze luggages. I got my carry-on and I got my main luggage. Most of my clothes are here. Actually, I carried Chris's clothes in there because Chris is coming out on Wednesday. So, because he's gonna carry the snowboard and I wasn't gonna do that, so. I feel like my tone changed a lot, I apologize. At the last day of the St. Lucia trip, Momo, my first dog, who lived with my ex, the kid's father, after we broke up, the dog I got at 18, the dog I wanted since kindergarten, my first chow, the only boy dog I've ever owned, take that however you want, he passed away. He passed away a few hours before I made it back, and it shook me. It really shook me. And people said, you know, you'll see signs. And I haven't experienced pet loss before. And when people say that, I don't know what they mean. You know, I know what they mean, but I don't know. I haven't experienced what they mean. I'll just show you guys. Look, I'm gonna send a picture to the kids because they've been going through it too. And I guess it's a coincidence, I know, but. And feeling so much guilt for not making it back in time was tough. He was getting old and he was having dementia in the final week while I was gone, and it was just
It was hard to hear, hard to see. But I did make the kids different jewelry pieces with his ashes. Ava has a bracelet, Mia has a necklace, and I made myself a ring. All right, I just had to share. Finishing off, getting ready for dinner. Look how long my roots have gotten. They're like to here. I haven't actually used this thing more than once. So, okay, I just got it like 2 days ago. But it feels like it's gonna give me the blow dry with less effort, like that smooth polish look. And because this is day one, I'm not too worried. It's not the best. It's not the best right now because I'm rushing. Morning sleigh. I'm in sweats, y'all. What?
Are you changing?
Or yeah. No, this is breakfast. This is breakfast, girl. Ooh. You did the buffet? Wait, is this? Wait. Look at you finding things.
Yeah.
Didn't think I was filming at breakfast. Mm-hmm. But we're filming at breakfast, so. Now, half of us have altitude sickness and half of us don't sleep well. No joke.
So we're back in the room after breakfast, getting ready for the shop. Gone a little ride up to the top for the launch party. Got back to the room last night and there was a Barefoot Dreams Sol de Janeiro pouch. Love that. And a mini Delicia drench. I kept this by my pillow because my eczema is just losing it at this altitude and this level of traveling. I feel like there's never too much deodorant. For example, I got this cute little set on, right? She's cute, I'll give you a better shot. I got leggings on underneath. Struggling to do my hair per usual. And then I gotta pick out what accessory to wear today. I'm gonna do a puffer vest. My hair is not gonna look this. I'm either gonna do muffs, alpaca beanie from my last trip to Colorado, yes, cause I went to go play with alpacas, if you guys remember that vlog. And then I have this checkered one. Or I can go full, you know. Can we have this a cute little moment, guys? So between you and me, this is my fourth or fifth. I can't keep up. I think it's fifth, but there's some inconsistencies somewhere in there. I don't know. I can't do math right now. 18, 24. It should be sixth season, but I don't know. I feel like it can't be. There's no way it's the sixth season. Snowboarding, right? So I learned to snowboard because Chris likes snowboarding. It's like that joke on TikTok where it's like, you know, you guys should have similar activities. But I really enjoyed it. It became very peaceful to me. 2019, 2020, but then since then, since turning closer to 30, I'm 31 right now, turning 32 this year, I feel like my balance is way off. I've been doing balance boarding at home just to try to get it better, but like, I don't stretch enough, even though I do it every day, I don't stretch enough. I definitely don't muscle train enough the past 2 years as I should. I was way better, you know, 21, 22 than 22, 23. I get really nervous snowboarding now. Like, I feel like my body isn't listening to my mind. My mind knows what to do, but my body's not balancing. My body's not putting the pressure on the bright part of my foot. It's not doing what I aim to do. So sometimes it goes surprisingly well. Chris said for someone who's like self-taught, aside from like YouTube videos, I took one class in the very beginning and the class went horribly. Wasn't my favorite instructor. He's like, you like progressed faster than he did, you know, type of thing. Then suddenly regressed. So that's the sum up of my story where I'm like, I regressed and I don't know if I'm going to snowboard well this trip at Aspen or with Chris when we go to Copper, but I hope it goes well because it was so peaceful to me. When Chris and I were talking about it, he's like, I hate that it brings you stress now. And it's more like I'm disappointed in my body for not keeping up with where I want to go, what I want to do. It's so fatigued. Everything cramps up. I have to take like magnesium supplements because my feet cramp up really bad, like generally, day to day. It's one of those moments where I like, this was a hobby for me and all of a sudden, like it's gone and that makes me sad. So wish me luck. I'm like screwing up this top layer because I'm rushing. Okay, friends, here's the outfit.
I always feel like this is the hallway for the shop. I mean, I have no natural light in my room at all. Amazon, TikTok, Princess Polly. All the links will be down below. I might tuck the strap and make this a little clutch moment, but she's cute. She's sweating. She got leggings on, as we know, underneath. butter in my bag. Butter in my bag. What we doing? Putting butter in our bag.
Okay. If y'all haven't tried it yet, I would love for y'all to head over to my Amazon shop, look at my favorites, support the Amazon, support the channel. I want to be able to say my people came through, if you know what I mean. And I love you guys so, so much for always supporting me. Like, y'all know y'all the friends before friends, right? Y'all been the peeps before the peeps. Let me know down below what order you do your things. I usually do makeup, hair, clothes, but today I do makeup, clothes, hair, because I was like, well, my hair ain't the worst, but my clothes need to be on, right?
Yeah.
Picked up Talitha from her room, but she forgot her gloves, so she ran back to get them. So she should be popping out any second now. But we are gonna head up to the gondola ride and to the mountaintop party. So, see y'all there. There she is. There she is.
Hello.
Her hair. Take off our under layers.
It's hot, you guys.
We sweating, and we don't, especially you're in gray.
I'm in gray.
I'm not doing this.
Like,
yeah.
Sweat works.
It's not actually cold. There is no wind to be found.
Yeah.
They did not show up for attendance.
Probably like 50 degrees out, maybe? 40?
It's supposed to be 20.
There's no way.
I don't know what this
is,
but.
It's too hot to be. Maybe because we're used to cold weather.
Yeah. We're cold adjusted.
Yeah. So it's not that cold to us.
And even though we're not like snowboarding or skiing right now,
mm-hmm.
we're breaking a sweat.
Yeah.
Y'all don't understand how much effort, yes. So we are venturing into the lodge. Morning. So I just came back from my massage, barely awake. Look at my baby hairs. Got my little ruby robe. I got a yellow one last time, so this is cute. Got both colors, team 62 and team 59. I'm just a little scrambled because I guess some logistic happened that I wasn't informed about, so my massage got moved up 2 hours and I woke up at 8, the massage was at 8, I got massage at 10. So that's why I look scrambled, am scrambled, I'm out of breath. I'm getting a little lightheaded. Oh, I think I got up too fast because I have a headache. I got up and I ran. Which is the after ski hangout. And because I didn't have time to get ready earlier and my nose been running, we need to refresh as quick as possible. It went fine. I did fine. I just used it as a warm-up day basically because I'm riding the rest of the week. So I had the honor of teaching It's My Ray Ray how to snowboard. So me and her have been chilling and we agreed we're gonna stay in our outfits. So I don't got a lash on. I don't got sunglasses. Girls. Okay. It's not the worst. This is touch level. But my nose. Quick refresh, because ain't nobody trying to smell. I wish I could change out of my thermals, to be honest, but like then I'll freeze. And there's nothing cute about like wearing a sweater under overalls, you know what I mean? I just don't think my thermals fit the way would like them to fit. They're comfy. I think Ray's about to pop up in a second and we're about to go up to the deck. I decided to go, just, you know, full on out, but I got lash on, barely. Lip, refresh the under eye. Didn't really have time to do the hair, so I just like brushed it real good, put the hat on, right? So hopefully that will do, because it's better to be a little bit more on time, but it's been a long day and my nose has been running the whole freaking time. So, and then I got eyelash glue in my eye.
The boys, the management. Yeah, have fun. Are you sick of managing us?
Never.
Never. I'm sick of that.
Maybe reunite in another trip soon.
Yeah. Maybe next month we're back. Aspen.
Again?
You should pull people.
Where are we going? Where are we going?
Vlogging.
Hello, vlog.
Hello.
We only get a few talking clips because the music gets copyrighted real quick. So.
Oh my God, you're so smart. I didn't think about that.
Yeah, we got a montage and all. Yeah. I took this from the party upstairs because I feel like we're supposed to have it. Peace out, puffy eyes. Ice roller. I was already getting in on this food because where am I going to be? Say it with me now. I will be by the food at every single occasion. Out of breath because I just took my beanie off. I had my beanie on. And then I actually put on a big old coat because it got chilly. I came down and grabbed my coat. I was like, yo, I'm probably looking crazy. But for what it is, especially outside, they said I look nice. So that's a very sweet. The girls are so sweet. I got to meet Ray. Y'all saw Ray. Ray, you know, been around since I've been around. The YouTube girlies. Right now, I'm going to work. I'm going to voice over. I'm going to edit. I'm going to post things. So if you aren't following on, y'all should do. Y'all should do. TikTok Insta. Yeah. I don't got a lot of snowboarding footage for y'all because I was teaching. I decided to teach Ray and I don't want to be that friend who leaves anybody on the mountain. So I was not going to leave the bunny slope. I wasn't going to go up there because I'm not going to drag her up there and let her get hurt. And then she was having such a fun time. It's her first time snowboarding and I was happy to help her. So whatever she needed, no problem. It's so hard to vlog at the parties because the music. YouTube going to be like, absolutely not. Absolutely not. You tried it. All right. Okay. So we are refreshed for dinner. We got our makeup back on. That overhead lighting will get you. I didn't know if I wanted to go bodysuit or if I wanted to go this cute little dress. See what would be cute about this dress. This is how they have it styled on the model, right? I'm gonna put on boots and a jacket. Cute, I brought my belt. What I would like is a little bit of this. I would like all this excess to be handled, or even if it wasn't bunched like this, if it was just like flat. Literally, who thought I'd ever have to say that I'm not hydrated enough? That's 100%. Alcohol will be giving me headaches up here, and I'm not even a drinker. Like, you get one drink out of me at best. And earlier y'all saw us do some wellness shots, which were green, it looked like spinach and cucumber. It tastes like that too, but it wasn't bad. It was probably apple juice based. I've been keeping my shoes in this little cubby. I've been using the other cubby for like dirty clothes, but it got all chaotic earlier when I ran in to switch clothes. Today has been the most fast-paced day, even though it was supposed to be free day. It did not feel as free as it should have been. But I didn't wear my mic at all this trip because I would have lost it. I really would have lost it. So I hope you guys still enjoy. And this is the outfit I'm wearing to the airport. It's my Zara sweatsuit I came in. Some thick socks because there's a snowstorm today. And I didn't get to wear the stage coat yet, so I'm gonna wear the stage coat. I haven't decided if I'm gonna wear the Hokas that I came in, which are great airport shoes, but the airport's so small. I'm not gonna be going very long, so I might not need these. I might just put them in my book bag. Go with the warmer option, which are these Sorels because they're very lightweight and flexible, but they're warmer. This one's already closed at full extension because my big white Sherpa coat needs this full extension. Otherwise, I think we're fine. Got my baby's bag, this is my camera bag, and then my book bag. So I think most of the girls have to get out of their rooms within the next 15 minutes who are leaving earlier. I have late checkout because I'm leaving so much later. When we get there, John, who is probably my future brother-in-law, hello John, is out here playing rugby. So He's usually, you know, in Virginia with us, but he's out here for 6 months from Denver, but he's in Denver. So he's gonna pick me up from the airport and we're gonna, you know, either grab some food or head back to the Airbnb and wait for Chris to show up with a rental car because he's a little bit, you know, behind, unless I get delayed.
This is the best flight ever.
Where are you going? Fort Lauderdale. How about yourself? Just to he does, yeah. He's signed into the game.
Weird, right?
No, it's not. Okay, yeah. Like, it's like,
oh yeah! Oh my god, I'm so excited. Place I went to yesterday when my brother-in-law picked me up. We're gonna hang out with John later this evening, but he's busy for a little bit, so we're gonna do like a mini hand roll situation, you know, so we're not starving. So
pre-dinner.
So I'm not hangry. Who wants to be hangry? Do you want me to be hangry?
Yes.
Do you want to die? I never expect that answer, but we got a little short day of snowboarding today, a longer day tomorrow. I changed my outfit. I put on my Aspen sweatshirt and my TikTok puffer vest, mini pre-dinner, and then we'll probably go out, eat a real dinner with John, and then go hit up round one because it's almost like a travel tradition at this point. Wherever we are, if there is a round one,
yeah,
we'll go hang out there for a little bit.
Compare, contrast, have fun.
Christopher, you're so red right now. Yeah. The brake lights. Christopher's not really a sushi person, but there are things there.
Except for, what is the one? The seared fatty tuna.
You like seared salmon, seared fatty salmon.
Yeah. That's good.
It's very creamy. Mia loves it too.
Everything else questionable. Not questionable.
Okay. Not your thing.
Not my thing.
Not your thing.
Not my cup of peach tea.
Okay, that works. We'll call it that from now on. There's like blue crab and there's lobster. So those are, you know, not raw at all. So he can eat those for sure. And he tries everything though. Let's not give Christopher the wrong impression. He has grown so much in the last 8 years we've been together. Because I swear to God, that man was burger, French fries, chicken nuggets.
My food palate has expanded like 100-fold. And that's like no exaggeration. It used to be one. And now I like 100 new dishes thanks to Saint-Mage.
Don't call me that. He trusts my judgment and we love that, because I'm such a foodie. Then I like, I would say a pretty wide variety of things. I'm not very, you know, picky about many things. It's a cheesesteak place.
I didn't show you guys the Airbnb, and it's kind of sad because it's a little messy right now. So I'm going to show you guys after packing some B-roll clips. It's probably my favorite Airbnb we've stayed at, and I definitely could see myself staying in it again because it is honestly like the perfect size. I was telling Chris that if I was single in Denver, no family, no kids, all that, this is probably what my place would look like. I love it. I love the doors. I love the handles. I love the size. I love the lighting. I love the windows. Like, you know how many plants I could have with all of these windows? There's even a plant. Basically, it's the last night. We went out to dinner, and I'm going to be packing the rest of the evening, and then we leave first thing in the morning, so it's 9:24 right now, and our flight's at, like, 10-ish tomorrow, and then we get home in the afternoon. If my clothes weren't literally, like, there's, like, a pile of jackets. I packed so many jackets for the trip over here, but you can get a little glimpsey around. It's perfect. It's beautiful. I love it so much, and it was affordable and it's convenient, and the most important part was it had parking. It had an outdoor parking spot. I did a little shopping yesterday. I got some new boots, which require new bindings. They're step-on bindings, so they're like, for those snowboarding, get what I'm saying, but for those who don't snowboard, you have a boot. You usually have like straps to go over. This one doesn't need it. It just clicks right into place. So I'm really excited to get those. It was a bit of a mission, so we didn't get as much riding done as we wanted to this trip. So hopefully we get out somewhere either locally or here again before that snowboarding itch comes back. I figured we could pick our giveaway winner right now together, and then I'll give you guys some B-roll of packing the box from our last sole giveaway. And then you guys can check the pinned comment down below for this one. Oh, Victoria won.
Victoria.
I know Victoria. Victoria commented quite a bit too. The funniest thing right now is my sister just figured out I got tattoos. So she was like, wait, what? Because on Instagram I did a little teaser video for my tattoos, and you guys have seen them. I guess I should give you a glance at them before I say goodbye for the evening. Christopher, could you help me with this? It's not on Zoom.
Both are just one.
Where do both? And this one you said it looks better if I tilt my head because of the saran wrap.
Yeah. Is that? But it's, I mean, it is what it is. I don't think you can fix it.
I don't know if I gave you guys the explanation of the tattoos, but. So the explanation of the tattoos, which of course everything's always personal. The one with the sparkles, dual meaning. One, it's a Virgo constellation. I thought that was pretty cool because that's never going to change. And I vibe with the zodiac. Obviously, I'm not a super invested person, but I do love it. And my middle name is Star. Yes, Star from birth. Some of you guys already know that. So, sparkles, stars, Virgo. You know, that was a me thing. So I got a me tat. I kind of just like the just width of it all, but like nothing too like shaded or anything. Very fine line, which is my aesthetic. Other side, I wanted to get something for the kids. All of the kids. I was originally, when I first wanted to get a tattoo about a year and a half ago, I was gonna do a birth flower bouquet of both of the children's birth flowers. And I like that idea, and a lot of people have that idea, and that's no problem. But then I really like the look of script too. So the script is okay. and I know it's kind of like, you know, kind of casual, but it's everyone's initials. So Mia's and Momo's, who some of you guys know recently passed. So they are the M's of my life. And then K for Callie, A for Ava, Y for Yuna. All the children, all the dogs, all the humans, all the babies, all of my girls, and my boy Momo. So eventually I do want to get like outlines of the dogs as well. I just don't know about placement and stuff like that yet. So this is just like a slow start. And I love my artist. I'll definitely be back. So if you want to check her out, I will put her info right here. I do believe she shares the space with her sister, who also does other services. So check them out. Check them out if you're in the Denver area. And I did sit with the idea for like a year just getting tattoos. And then I sat with these specific ideas for like 6 months just to make sure I'm an indecisive girl. That's probably why I never got any yet. So thank you guys for watching. I hope you guys enjoyed coming along with another trip. There are other trips being hinted at. I don't know how much this mama's gonna travel. I do think there's a trip in April that I am pretty locked in for. But for anything else, to be determined. So keep up with me where you want to keep up with me. Check out all the videos, because even on like my TikTok and such like that, I do like a quicker version of these vlogs and then longer vlogs for those who would like to see it. How do I end these vlogs? I don't even know how I end them. Do I end them like I usually do? Thank you guys for spending part of your day with me. If you are interested in my recent uploads, I'll put them on the screen right now, and I'll see you guys in a later video.